A triangular graph, also known as a ternary plot, shows the relationship between three sets of variables. They are useful when three data sets combined add up to 100%. For example, this diagram shows the proportion of silica, titomagnetite, and calcium carbonate in sand. To construct a triangular graph, we first need some data. I have some data for the primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors of an economy for 12 countries as shown in the table on the screen.
Now first we need to draw an equilateral triangle. Each axis needs to be divided into 100, representing the percentage. Now we're going to draw each axis 10 centimeters long. So first, I will draw the bottom horizontal axis 10 centimeters long. And from left to right, I'm going to mark it out in 1 centimeter intervals. And each centimeter is going to represent 10%. So we'll start with 0 in the bottom left hand corner and go 10.
20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100.
Now, when we've done this, we are going to draw a vertical line from the 50% mark here straight up the page. And we're going to rub this line out later. The purpose of this line is it's going to help us join our other two 10 centimeter lines. Now I'm going to draw two 10 centimeter lines, which are going to run from the 0% and 100% marks of the horizontal axis until they meet on this vertical line that I drew in the earlier step. So that's about 10 centimeters there. And that there will be 10 centimeters on that side. Now we just got to mark out our scale again, just like we did earlier. Here we'll label our axis, and we'll make our horizontal one, we'll make this the agriculture, make this one industry on the right here, and on the left here make this services. And now we can rub out this vertical line in the middle. We don't need it anymore. Now I'm going to draw in three sets of parallel lines for all three axes. And they're going to be drawn at a 60 degree angle. So the 10% here will join up with the 90% on this line. So we'll carry these all the way across. We'll do the other side. And we'll also do these horizontal ones. Okay, that looks nice. Now I'm ready to plot the points for our 12 countries. I will do this by finding the point where all three elements intersect. Now Angola, for example, has 10.2% employed in agriculture. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run my pen along the scale for agriculture here until it reaches the 10% mark, and that is there. Okay, now the next figure is 61.4% for industry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run my other pen here along the scale for industry on the right here until it reaches 61%, and that is about there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use both pens and I'm going to follow the lines until I find the point at which they both intersect. Now watch this. Intersects about here. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just put a little star, little cross there, and I will write ANG for Angola, which I'll later put in a key. Okay, now if I follow this line here to the services scale, you'll see that it roughly comes to about 28%. Now, if I add that 28% to the 10% and the 61% that I did earlier, it of course comes to 100%. Now I will plot the data for the other 11 countries. Now I've almost finished my graph and I've added a key on the right hand side. And now I'm going to give it an appropriate title. We're going to call this a triangular graph showing GDP composition by sector. Now here is my completed graph.